The 2018 Asia Pacific Fistball Championships being held in Melbourne, Australia. We are ready for the two arch rivals, the women's teams of Australia and New Zealand, to go head to head. Please welcome both teams as they run out onto the field. Introducing the Australian team and the captain, number 7, Brooke Mackay. Number 1, Jess Lyon. Number 2, Lindsay Lehman. Number 4, Alex Trezias. Number 5, Tess Feary. Number 8, Bethan Jones. Number 10, Erin Donnellan. Number 11, Jesse Smith. And number 18, Tiny Ashworth. And the coach of the Australian team, Bianca Crook. Introducing the New Zealand team and the captain of the team, Annalise Osterbaan. Number 4, Melanie Vanort. Number 5, Caitlin Steele. Number 6, Elizabeth Meacham. Number 9, Catherine Engel. Number 12, Louise Thayer. And the coach of the New Zealand team, Vicky Buston. The referee of the game will be Christoph Oberlenner from Austria. Can you please be upstanding for the Australian national anthem? Please remain standing for the national anthem of New Zealand.
Thank you.
So we are ready. Both teams, since they have met in January in Christchurch this year, have improved considerably, and we're ready for a good game today.
Serious?
Australia will be playing left of screen, New Zealand right, and Australia will take the first serve by Tani Ashworth. Long serve by Tani Ashworth sees Australia take the first point, 1-0. The ball going wide, New Zealand take the first point of their set, and the scores are tied at 1-1. Going underneath the net, and Australia level up on 2-2. New Zealand taking their third point, and they lead 2-3. Melanie Renault sending the ball deep into the back line there. Australia unable to get it back. 2-4. Cracking shot there by Melanie Benoit, finding the sideline perfectly. Good precision, 2-5, New Zealand.
I'll never get precision right. Precision. Very precise.
The defence by Jesse Smith, not enough to get Australia that point. 2-6, New Zealand lead. New Zealand taking a dominant lead in the first set. They now lead by 5 points, 2-7. Timeout, Australia. Louise there throwing everything at that. Unfortunately, not getting the point. Australia get one back. 3-7, New Zealand lead. Zealand now lead by 5 points, 3-8. Benord almost taking out the entire net. 4-8, New Zealand lead. The men's Australian captain trying to get the Australian women's team in advantage. The referee right onto it. Brooke Mackay smashing the ball perfectly there, and Australia pick up their 5th point, 5-8 New Zealand lead. Melbourne Ort sending that ball well past the end line. 6-8 New Zealand. First serve by Louise Thayer, unplayable by the Australian team, 6-9 in New Zealand lead. Brooke Mackay just hitting that ball wide. New Zealand pick up their 10th point, and that gives them set point, 6-10. And that's the set. New Zealand take out the first set of the match, 1-0 New Zealand.
Oh, super smash that from Benoit. Aimed it perfectly, put a perfect weight on it. No chance for the Australians to get that back. It's 1-1. Bit of a mishit, and that's all it takes. The Australians take another lead. They're up by two, first time in this match. So, well, no, sorry, it's 2-1. Said it before today, it is a game of inches, Fistball. Just half an inch there, and that would have been a perfect shot from Tanae Ashworth. But unfortunately, this time it's 2-2. Fantastic shot there. We give a lot of credit to the attackers, but that was beautifully played out from the back and through the middle as well. Fantastic from New Zealand. They're up 3-2. Serve called out. It's 4-2 to New Zealand. Just a little too deep there from Louise Thayer, and Australia take the point. 4-3 New Zealand. The eyes lit up, but unfortunately the shot went under, and the Australians tie up the second set. 4-4.
I'm very upset.
And another. Another cracking smash there from Vanort, but beautifully set up by the New Zealanders. That's Elizabeth Meacham. Fantastic play.
Got the wrong one.
Just out of reach there for Brooke McKay. The New Zealanders tie things up, 5-5. Not quite enough on that one, unfortunately, but valiant effort all the same. But the Australians take the lead here in the second set, and a timeout is called by New Zealand. It's got them rattled. The Australians in the ascendancy in the second set here. It's 1-0 New Zealand. Second set again, 6-6.
Yes, it's 5. Yeah, apparently New Zealand and Australia, I think it's come along, it's like 7-7. It's pretty awesome.
And a beautiful drop shot there from Brooke McKay. When it comes off, it looks fantastic. And the Australians take the lead again. It's a back-and-forth battle in the second set. It is the final of the Asia-Pacific Championships after all.
Just finding plugs to charge their phones is mad. So good.
Yeah. almost the perfect setup from Jess Lyon vs Lyon there. Unfortunately, just a touch a bit too close, and the point goes to New Zealand. 7-7. Can't touch the net on the serve, unfortunately. So the point goes to New Zealand. Australia will serve again. New Zealand back in the lead in the second set. Said it before, I'll say it again, game of inches, Fistball. Half an inch there, and that would have been a perfect strike. As it is, New Zealand have given up the lead 8-8 in the second set. Bit too much from Brooke McKay there. Showed some good power, just slightly out on the right hand side. Australia fall behind again. It's 9-8 to New Zealand. Remember, score goes to 11 in the second set. So Australia won't want New Zealand to score this point. Pivotal part of the match here. Great effort from Caitlin, fists of steel there, but not quite far enough in Australia. Pivotal point and they've snatched it. It's 9-9. Excellent shot, excellent setup. The New Zealand's front line really does work well together. And they've taken that point to make it set point. The Australians are serving. Remember, it's best of five, so the Australians really want to score this point and force the set a little longer. Oh, and it's out on the right-hand side. And the New Zealanders take the second set, and it's 2-0. Remember, this best of five. All set up for the epic comeback in the final for the Australians, but they can't afford to drop anymore.
Best of seven. All right.
Apologies for my mistake earlier. I've just been informed that it is in fact best of seven in the finals for the Asia Pacific Women's Championships. Still 2-0 to New Zealand, however. Valiant effort there from the Australians. Unfortunately, not able to get it back over Tess Ferry with a dive. 1-0 to New Zealand.
Let's go, Tony!
Bad luck there for the New Zealanders, pushing it out to the right, and tie it up this third set. 1-1. Oh, beautifully weighted serve from Melanie Vinort there, and it's 2-1. Brilliant drop serve from Tanae Ashworth, and great commitment from both the New Zealand front line, Van Oort and Thayer. Fantastic effort there from the Australians, but a beautifully weighted shot from Louise Thayer, and the New Zealanders have tied up the game. It's a really scintillating fistball here. It's a really fantastic effort, great skill. It's great to see. The umpires adjudicated that Van Oort touched the net there, which is a foul. So the point goes to Australia. Well wide there from the Australians. New Zealanders picked up on that straight away. Still a tight one though, so anyone's set. Australia to serve. Thank you.
No, there's
Oh, and the ball just touches the net on the way through, and what was a fantastic smash. Unfortunately, that means the point goes to New Zealand. Unfortunate if you're an Australian fan, of course, but not if you're a New Zealander. Oh, perfectly placed from Van Oort. But a fantastic rally there between both teams. Fistball, much like life, it's all about communication, and you can hear them talking to each other out there. And so it's producing some fantastic rallies, as we saw just now. The score, though, is 5-3 to New Zealand. Tania Ashworth with the beautifully placed serve. No chance that was coming back. And keeping the Australians in it. The substitution coming from New Zealand. Number six, that would be any time now.
Elizabeth Meacham
coming off. And Catherine Engel coming on. Right off the side of the fist. Unfortunately, the Australians look to be calling timeout, and the umpire has seen it. Not happy the way things going, Coach Bianca. So a timeout to calm things down and make sure the Australians can stay in the set.
It's 3-6 to 0 in the 57 final game.
serve, looking to wrap it up. Oh, and you can see Vanort spying the angle the whole way through, and precise shot there. It's 1-0 to New Zealand.
Stuck on my words there.
Fantastic work at the back from Australia to get that one over there, but New Zealand still able to score the point and take a 3-0 lead. Sorry, 2-0 lead. The score was in the way. I don't know if Annalisa Oosterbaan's nickname is the metronome. Perhaps it should be, because that was perfectly placed as it was each time before. And New Zealand do take that 3-0 lead that we alluded to earlier. Oh, beautiful shot there from Brooke McKay. Even though she's wearing sunglasses, you could see this glint in her eyes as you lined up that shot and placed it perfectly. It's 3-1. Australia is staying in it. Fantastic effort from Tanae Ashworth, but just a bit too far on that occasion. Unable to return the ball. And New Zealand take a 4-1 lead. Australia to serve.
Exactly.
Brilliant effort there from the Australians, and Tess Ferry in particular, to diving, refusing to give up this grand final. And Australia 2, New Zealand 4. unlucky there. Fantastic effort and good communication from Brooke McKay, but unfortunately the ball did end up out. And she'll take the serve, and down by three. Great shot there from New Zealanders. Move out to 6-2 here in the pivotal and deciding fourth set, potentially, unless the Australians can grab a few more points. The Ustaban Van Oort combination has been a rich source of points for New Zealand, and is once again, as they take a 7-2 lead, closing in on that championship trophy. Can Australia pull it back? Oh, it's fantastic effort from the Australians. And unfortunately, though, New Zealand score another point, closing in the 11 points required. Australia call a timeout, and we'll head away to try and bring this back. But really, the effort has been absolutely incredible on the Australian girls. And yeah, credit to them. And a perfectly placed smash there from Van Oort. It's been a feature of today's game. Closing in, just 2 points required now for New Zealand to claim the Asia Pacific Championship. Australia battling on. And that's heading out, beautifully set up by Tess Ferry and beautifully smashed by Brooke McKay. Australians aren't giving up. And score now 9-3. Beautifully placed. That was fantastic. Great communication, skill, and precision. And New Zealand now, championship point. Oh, so close, but unfortunately touched the net there. And Australia will take that point. And New Zealand still serving for the championship. And that's it. The match is over and New Zealand claimed the Asia Pacific Women's Championship for 2018. A big round of applause for New Zealand woman there. Fantastic work. And a round of applause for the Australian woman too, because their effort today has been fantastic and the improvement has been amazing as well. They'll be back, but congratulations to New Zealand woman. Presentations will be after the men's final, I've been told. But so stick around for those. But congratulations again. And as the New Zealand woman and Australian women's teams congratulate each other on another fantastic match. Remember, the men's final is coming up in the next few minutes, so great opportunity to grab final drinks and so forth to sit down and get into that one. Those who aren't aware, the first match of the tournament between the Aussies and the Kiwis went to 7 sets, the full amount, so an absolutely cracking and epic match there. So look forward to another one just like that, but this time with the trophy on the line coming up.